Hi guys, what's going on? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial. And today in this video, we are going to continue the last session, which is the reward video ad tutorial. So that is, we have already discussed about the how to just create a new ad unit for the reward video ad inside the AdMob website. And a little bit we have discussed about the how actually the reward video ad work. And also we have designed the layout for the reward video ad inside the Android Studio. So simply let me show you once again. It is actually a button and a text view, and the idea is going to be like when the button is clicked, it will be going to bring up a reward video ad, and once the user completely watch the video and close the ad, then it will be going to simply update the text view, which is going to be updating the coins. So let's get started. So first of all, what we have to do is that we have to make sure that the ad dependency is ready. So click on the ad view from here, and it will bring up a small pop-up in which you have to simply press OK. And what it actually do is that you can see inside this module app build file, there is a new dependency, which is the player service ads. Then so you can manually do this line. You can simply write this line and click on the sync from here, and that's all you have to do. And once it is done, you can simply move to the main activity, and we have to add the reference for the button and text view. Okay, so once that done, what we have to do is we have to add the reward video ad. I want to name it as reward ad equal to then mobile ads, then get in reward video ad instance. That is going to be the context, which is this. And in case if you're doing this inside a fragment activity, then you can simply replace this with get activity, get application context, or something like that. And yeah, now what we have to do next is that we have to add reward video ad, then we have to load the ad. So load ad. And inside the double quotes, I'm going to paste this sample AdUnit ID. So I will also add the link in the description below this video to this sample AdUnit ID for the reward video ad, native ad, interstitial ad, and the banner ad, which is actually offered by the Google itself. And once that done, what we have to do is we have to add the ad request. So that is new ad request builder.build. Okay, so finally we have to add mobile ads, then initialize and context again. Now we are almost ready, and finally what we have to do is we have to show the ad when the button is clicked. So the button is get coin in my case, so get coin is the variable name, then dot set one click listener, new one click listener. And inside that, what we have to do is we have to simply check if the ad is loaded. So if reward ad is loaded, and if it is loaded, we have to just simply show that. So reward video ad dot show. And if it is not loaded, so that is going to be else, we have to load it. So reward video ad, then load ad, which is going to be the same line. So just copying this from here, pasting it here. Okay, so yeah, that's it. Now we have to simply change the, we have to update the number of coins when the user completely watch the ad. Okay, so now we have to make sure that the coin is updated once the user completely watch the ad. So reward ad, then set reward ad listener, new, then reward ad listener. And now you can see it automatically added all these methods, which is really useful. And what we have to do is that we have to simply find this one, which is onRewarded, which means the user completely watched the ad and it's time to update the coin, number of coins. So I'm going to create an integer outside this onCreate method. So int coin amount. Okay, so I want to name it as coin amount equal to zero. So in my case, I want to give zero number of coins when the user start the application for the first time. So if you want to give it as 10, you can simply change the zero into 10. And yeah, that's it. Now we have to simply add, we have to simply give the new number of coin once the user watch the complete ad. So I'm going to give it as coin amount equal to coin amount plus 10. So I want to give 10 coins once the user completely watch the full ad. So I want to give it as 10. Maybe like 15 is better, or 10 is okay. Okay. Now we have to update the text view according to the changed coin number. So text view is the current coin. So coin dot set text. Then I want to add a symbol style that is going to be the same way. Inside the text, you can see I added the coins equal then 0. I want to just add it here, then plus coin amount. Now it's everything is okay, and yeah, everything is well perfect. And yeah, finally what we have to do is we have to give the permission for the internet usage. So go to the Android manifest, and inside that we have to add these two lines, and once that done, we are almost ready. So yeah, now let's go and try this in a real Android device. Okay guys, so we have the Android app in the Android device, and yeah, everything is working perfect. The number of coins is 0 right now. So let's go and press the get coin button, and here is the ad. And once the ad has been completed, I'm closing it, and now you can see the number of coins updated into 10 from 0. So that's it. So if you like this video, then give it a big thumbs up, and we are almost completed the AdMob session in this tutorial series. As always, thanks for watching. Peace out.